Roy following up with the play, but it comes over. Rifle scores! Pulia!
It's not Bernier's night. I mean, these are goals that Bernier has to have, and he doesn't miss. Not like this.
Three goals on four shots. Oh, my goodness.
That's why he's on the end of the bench.
That was struck with ferocity, let me tell you.
By the Maple Leafs. They're just trying to keep the Rangers in check.
That puck got through Bernier! Derek Stepan gets the goal! And behind that card, I wonder if Mike Babcock was muttering to himself. But there's a gift goal for the Rangers. It's 2-1.
It dipped, but it doesn't matter when you take a wrist shot from this far out. It doesn't matter how far it dips. It did not bounce in front of him. That just landed right. You'll see it here. It's just a short bounce right between him. But you got to stop it. Plain and simple.
Wow.
And earlier in the season, aside from the seven games prior to this, where James Reimer found his game and goal for Toronto. Now Toronto has been given a soft goal.
Averitt. Averitt pass. This could be a nice goal. Scores! Oh my! Jonathan Quick of Los Angeles had a brain cramp, and Jonathan Bernier has had one here.
You thought it was going to be icy, didn't you?
I did, and they're discussing it now.
Because now, of course, you don't have to wait till somebody touches it.
Did Bernier think that?
No, I think he just plain misplayed it. It was not touched, I believe. And as long as it's not touched, that's icing. And then it comes off the boards, and you can see the reaction by Jonathan Bernier on the play. He takes his eyes off the puck for a moment, and it goes off the inside of his skate into the net. He just plain fans on it.
The linesman down deep waved it off. No icing.
Yeah, and I...
My goodness!
If it hits a stick on the way, it's different, but if it doesn't...
Now Randy Carlisle is going to get the explanation from Brad Watson.
Isn't it if the goalie comes out to play it?
Yes.
However, the icing's waved off?
Well, there was never...
Off.
I don't believe
that... There was never an issue that...
There was never... He took off... Bounce off the glass and off his foot and into the net.
Oh my. 13:04, the time of the biggest break of this season.
Deflected puck. Russell wires a shot. There's a save for Bernier, but the Oilers get the puck and score! Bernier couldn't find the puck. Desharnais could. Letestu and Cassian with him on that line, and it's 4-0.
You mentioned trying to test Bernier early. He's played just 27 plus minutes in game 3 of round 1, and he thinks he has it, or at least deflected it into the corner. And another early break for the Oilers here. Watch Letestu, Jim. He's trying to actually pass this one across. He's looking for a man in front. It comes right back to him. The bounces early on in this game have all bounced the way of the Edmonton Oilers.
Erickson got a stick on that. Now at the line, here's Miller again. Erickson back to Miller. Long shot at the skate of Marshall. Gets a second whack at it. Here comes Krug, who fires a lot. And Jonathan Bernier down, and a penalty coming to Boston. As Jonathan Bernier on his knees was spilled and looks like
Bergeron number 15, minor penalty for interference.
And it'll be Ranger who gets the penalty for interference.
Well, Bergeron's in front of the net here. He's battling with Ranger, and as the play gets cycled around, Ranger pushes Bergeron on top of Bernier. You see Bernier's right leg trapped behind him. We get another look at it from this angle. Ranger pushes him back on top of Bernier, and Bernier hasn't moved from that position here for the last couple of minutes. So the Bruins, who have not had a power play tonight, will get there first with 11 and a half left.
And Ray, we saw Bernier in the morning skate today stretching frequently.
Come on,
during the 30 minutes or so he was on the ice, and he is not yet off one knee.
Well, can you imagine this?
He's out.
He's coming out. And
he's barely putting any weight on that left leg. So James Reimer will come in.
The bucket of pressure is just pouring over top of James Reimer now. What a tough spot to come into this hockey game. A power play for the Bruins. He hasn't played in a while. And when he has played, it hasn't gone very well lately.
He was pulled his last start against New Jersey, allowed 3 goals on 10 shots in 22 minutes. Remember, he relieved Bernier against Los Angeles and played one of his better games of the season. But what a spot to be put into.
Reimer gets a rather loud set of applause here from the fans as he comes into the game. Now, the Bruins are going to get this set up eventually, and so Reimer's first 15 seconds in net are going to be with Zdeno Chara standing right in front of him.
The number three power play in the NHL going to work. McGinley down to Chara. Back at the point is Krejci. Feeds across the Torrey group. He can hammer it as well. And here's Krug with some time. Across to Krejci. Chara providing a partially clips in front of the Toronto goal. Krug shoots! And Reimer reaches out and gloves it. And that brings the fans to their feet in Toronto.
Well, maybe it's something to rally around for the Leafs, who had played the first 9 minutes of this period in their zone. James Reimer is into the game. He's got his chance to play here, and he's got to be able to stem the tide. This Bruins power play has been so good this year. And Chara, who's really evolved as a net front guy, not just a screener anymore. He moves around much more. He makes nice little plays in front of the net. He's in front of Reimer, who gloves the Krug shot.
Shots are 8-0 Boston here in the second period. In the third period, rather. The faceoff, though, won by McClement. And Franzen sends it down. Jay McClement spends more time on the ice shorthanded than any forward in the NHL. Second consecutive year, he's led the league in that category. Quite likely no bigger kill of the season than this one for Toronto. Up to the line and squeezed out by McClement, who fires it down. Chara leads the Bruins with 10 power play goals on the year. Way up at the Toronto blue line is big number 33. Krug pounds it in.